In this session, the countries are as follows. In this session, the contents are information rate, numericals on entropy, and properties of entropy. Suppose we have information source which is generating the symbols S1, S2, S3 and so on. The rate at which the symbols are generated by the information source is called as information rate. It is called as information rate. The rate at which the symbols are generated are called as information rate. So symbols are generated at a fixed rate and it is denoted by RS, symbols per second. So the information rate RS is defined as average information content, which is nothing but entropy, into fixed time rate RS, symbols per second. This is rate at which symbols are generated, and this is the information rate. So it is defined as a product of average information content per symbol and the message symbol rate. RS is the message symbol rate. Okay. And hence I define the information rate as a product of H of S into RS. And this is the information rate, which is in bits per second. Let us define the information rate concept with an example. Consider a source S1, S2, S3 and S4. What are the probabilities? 1 by 2, 1 by 4 and 1 by 4 respectively. Self-information for each of the message has to be determined and entropy of the source, that is H of S. If I want self-information of symbol S1, then it is log of 1 by P1, which is 1 by 2. I get 1 bit. Next, for I2, log of 1 by 4, it is log 4, I get 2 bits. Next, for the third information, log of 4, I get 2 bits. Now, I know what is the definition for entropy. Summation I is 1 to Q. Here, the number of bits are I to 3, number of symbols. Pi, log 1 by Pi, we know what it is. It is information content II. So, here we have P1, P2, P3. We know what is P1, 1 by 2. Into, I got self-information as 1 plus 1 by 4 is the second probability. I got the self-information as 2 plus 1 by 4 is the third probability. I got the self-information as 2. So I get H of S as 1.5 bits per message symbol. As it is average information content, the unit will be bits per message symbol. Next problem. Source emits one of the four possible symbols with probabilities given here. I have to find the amount of information and entropy. So for symbol 0.4, next for symbol 1, 0.2, for symbol 3.1. So finally, if I want entropy, I should use self-information into the probability. Self-information into the probability. Self-information into the probability. I get entropy as 1.8465. Next problem. Discrete source emits one of the six symbols with the probabilities given here respectively. Find the source entropy, H of S, and information rate. How will you find the source entropy, H of S, log Pi, log 1 by Pi? So here, what is Pi? That is P1, 1 by 2, log of 1 by 2. Next is 1 by 4. Next is 1 by 8. Next is 1 by 16. Next 1 by 32. 1 by 32, I get H of S. Once I get H of S, I can find what is the information rate. What is the information rate given by R of RS is equal to small rs into H of S. I know H of S I have calculated. Now I want what is small rs. Okay. It emits one of the six symbols once every millisecond. Once every millisecond. This statement tells me the symbol rate. What is the symbol rate? One message symbol divided by, it is 1 by 10 power minus 3, one of the six symbols once every millisecond. So once every millisecond into H of S, what it is? 1.93 7.5. So I get this as 1937.5 bits per second. This will be the information rate. If we know the symbol rate, in order to find the symbol rate, it is given one message symbol every millisecond. So every 1 millisecond it is generated. That is giving us the symbol rate. Next problem. The output of information source consists of 115 symbols, 32 of which occur with probability 1 by 64, remaining 118 with 1 by 236. Source emits 2000 symbols per second. Let us find the information rate, average information rate. So here to find h of s for this problem, we know there are 150 symbols, 32 of which with occurring with probability 1 by 64. That is, I is 1 by 32, pi log 1 by pi. That is occurring with probability. What is the probability? 1 by 64 throughout. Okay. Next, remaining 118, that means 32 over 33 to 150. Because 150 total, that gives remaining 118 occurring with probability. What is the probability? 1 by 236. So I define 1 by 64 log to the base 264 plus 1 by 236 log to the base 2 1 by 236. This is giving me 6.9413. Once I have h of s with me, I can find rs is equal to small rs into h of s. What is small rs? See the problem. 2000 symbols per second source emits. Okay. So it is 2000 into what h of s you have got. That is giving me 13,882.6 bits per second. Next problem, a card is drawn from a deck. You are told it is a spade. How much information did you receive if the card drawn is spade? Second question, what is the information received if a card drawn is an ace? Third question, how much information is received if the card drawn is ace or spade? So, card having set, a deck will be having 52 cards. First one is, it is speaking of spade. Out of 52, there are 13 spades. So, probability of spade is 13 by 52. So, self-information will be log of 1 by 0.25. That will give me 2 bits. This is for self-information of spade. Next question is ace. There will be 4 aces in a deck of 42 cards. So, probability of ace is 4 by 52. And next, find the self-information. Next is ace of spade. Only one ace of spade is there. So, self-information ace of spade is log of 1 by 52 or log 52 is 5.7 bits. Next. So we know entropy represents average uncertainty of a source. Always more the uncertainty, we can identify what type of symbols will be transmitted. If the uncertainty is less, it is difficult to determine which of the symbol is transmitted. So let us go to the properties of entropy. We know that entropy now is a function of pk, because what is the what is the equation? It is pi log 1 by pi over the summation, or pk, anything, I or k. So now we know it is a function of probability. That means if pi varies, probability varies, entropy also varies. Okay. So I tell entropy is a function of probability, because h of s depends on probability. And if pk continuously varies from 0 to 1, so as the entropy function. That is, if probability varies continuously from 0 to 1, so as the entropy function. And when pk is 0 and 1, h of s vanishes, or h of s is 0 for two conditions of probability, 0 and 1. Hence, I call it as a symmetric function. Entropy maximum is given by log q to the base 2. It is given by log q to the base 2. This gives us h of s max. Source entropy maximum, where q is the number of symbols emitted by the source. Next property is, if I partitional symbols into subsymbols, does not affect the entropy. Source efficiency is very important. It is given by h of s by h of s maximum. We know what is h of s maximum. It is given by log q to the base 2, where q is the number of symbols. Next, emitted. Redundancy is 1 minus efficiency. We know what is h of s calculated. PL log 1 by PI. That is source entropy. It depends on probability. As the probability varies, as entropy also will vary. So I tell entropy is a function of probability. For probability values of zeros and ones, entropy is said to be zero. Let us deal with examples to calculate source efficiency and redundancy. A discrete message source emit two dependent symbols x and y, given probabilities 0.55 and 0.54. Calculate source efficiency and redundancy. Px and py are given. So h of s is given by px log 1 by px plus py log 1 by py. Substituting the probabilities, I get h of s as 0.9928. Next, to find hs efficiency, I need h of s by hs, h of s max. What is h of s max? H of s max is given by log q to the base 2. Here q is equal to 2 because you have two symbols x and y, so it is 1 bit per message symbol. So I substitute in this equation, I get what is the efficiency. If I want redundancy, it is 1 minus efficiency. So I get source efficiency and redundancy by using these equations. Next problem, collector voltage of a certain circuit is lie between minus 5 and minus 12 volt. Voltage can take on these values, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 9, minus 11, minus 12, with the probabilities. Determine the average self-information. That means you have to determine what is h of x, h of s, what is h of s? That is average source information or entropy. So it is P1 log 1 by PI. What are the probabilities? Given here, probabilities are 1 by 6, 1 by 3, 1 by 2. I am substituting in this equation over the summation. I is equal to 1 to how many symbols? 4, 5, 6. So I get entropy as 2.418 bits per message symbol. So x represents the outcome of a single roll of a fair die. What is the entropy of x? So we know that a die is having 6 phases. Probability of getting any number is 1 by 6. So what is px? 1 by 6. So what is the entropy of x? Px log 1 by 6. So I get entropy of getting one symbol. What is entropy of getting x? What is entropy of x? It is 0.431 bits per message symbol. Because a die is having 6 phases, probability of getting any number is 1 by 6. I have defined always entropy is equal to I is 1 to Q PI log 1 by PI. That means entropy is always the function of probability. That means as the probability varies, so as the entropy. But I have told that when probability is 0 and probability is 1, that is PK or PI, we see that entropy is equal to 0. So entropy vanishes between 0 and 1 of the at 0 and 1, probability of 0 and 1, entropy is 0, else it is going to vary continuously with the probability. That is the main function. This tells us entropy as a function of probability, where x-axis is our probability, y-axis is our h of s.